Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve problem 4-101 that is taken from chapter number 4, Axial Load, and book name is Mechanics of Materials by RC Hibbeler. So statement is the rigid lever arm is supported by two A36 steel wires having the same diameter of 4 mm. If force of 3 kN is applied to the handle, determine the force developed in both wire and their corresponding elongation. Consider A36 steel as an elastic, perfectly plastic material. So you can see this is the handle where there is a 3 kN load applied and these are two steel wires of 4 mm diameter. So you have to find the forces in this wire as well as elongation. Now you can see due to this force, there will be elongation in wire AB and CD. So what we will do is that first step is that we will find these forces. So this handle tends to increase the length of this wire AB. As a result, this wire AB applied force that will act downward. So this, if we remove this force, this wire AB will exert a force downward. Let this force is FAB. Similarly, if you remove this wire CD, so this will also exert a vertical force FCD in downward direction. And this at point E, there is a pin support. So as a result of this, if you remove this support, so there will be a horizontal reaction force, which is equal to EX. And there will be a vertical reaction force, which is represented as EY. Now we'll find this FAB and FCD by using equation of equilibrium. So what are these equation of equilibrium? So first equation of equilibrium is that sum of all moments about point E is equal to zero, taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So about point E, these two forces are passing through point E, so they are not producing moment. So only the moment which is producing moment about point E is the first one, is this P, and perpendicular distance is 450, and this is producing clockwise moment, so it will be negative. So I will write P, which is 3 kN, so 3000 multiplied by 450, and this is producing counterclockwise movement, so it is negative. The second movement is due to FCD, and perpendicular distance is this 150. And since this is producing counterclockwise movement, so it will be positive. So I will write plus FCD into 150. And the last force, which is producing about movement about point E, is FAB into perpendicular distance is 300. And this is also producing counterclockwise, so it will be positive. So I will write plus FAB into 300 is equal to, the sum of all moments about point E will be equal to zero. So if you divide this equation by 150 on both sides, so you will get 2 times FAB plus FCD is equal to 9000. Let this is your equation number 1. Now we can see that due to this load of P, this wire AB and CD elongates. So as a result, this point AB comes toward this. This will be new point A dash, and C will come toward this point, and let this point is C dash. So this change in length between A and A dash is del A, change in length of AB, and from A to C it is this one, del CD. Okay, so this will be a straight line at this point. Let me draw it again. It will be a straight line because we assume that this is linear elastically perfectly plastic material. So this is your point C. Okay, now what we will do is that we will perform another analysis, that is elastic analysis. Let me write it, elastic analysis, and we have assumed that these material wires are elastic, perfectly plastic material. So you can see that there are two similar triangle. One is this one, clear, and another one is this one. So if we take the ratio of their side, for example, if I take change in length of AB divided by this total length, which is equal to 300 millimeter. So it will be del AB divided by 300 will be equal to del CD divided by 150. So from here, what I will get is that del AB change in length of wire AB will be equal to 300 divided by 150 multiplied by change in length of CD. And if you further simplify it, change in length of AB will be equal to 2 times change in length of CD. Now we know that change in length is equal to force FAB into length AB divided by A into E. Since area is same, because both have same diameter, so area will be same. And 2 multiplied by change in length of CD will be equal to FCD into LCD divided by A into E. So again, if you further simplify it, this A will cancel with this A, and material is same, A36 steel. So I will, and length are also same, so these will cancel. So we will get this FAB is equal to 2 times FCD. So this will be our equation number 2. Okay. Now what we are going to do is that we will find the normal stress in each wires. So how we'll find that? Let me write it, normal stresses. But before normal stresses, what I will do is that if I solve this equation 1 and 2, solving equation 1 and 2 simultaneously, so put, or you can also put equation number 2 in equation number 1. So let's put it, FAB is 2 times FCD, so 2 multiplied by 2 FCD plus FCD is equal to 9000. So when you solve this, you will get force in wire CD will be equal to 1800 Newton. So if you have this FCD, so put FCD in equation number 2, so you will get FAB is equal to 2 times FCD, so 2 multiplied by 1800 Newton will give you FAB, that will be equal to 3600 Newton. So these are the two forces in wire AB and CD. Now we will check stress in these wires. So normal stress in wire CD will be equal to FCD divided by area of CD. So FCD is 1800. The diameter of wire is given 4 millimeters. So area will be pi by 4. And 4 millimeter in meter is 0.004. pi by 4 d square. So when you solve this, this will be equal to 143.24 mega pascal. Since we are given the A36 material steel, so from property table its value is 250 mega pascal. So you can see that stress in CD is less than yield stress. This is 143.24 mega pascal, which is less than 250 megapascal. So it means that the stress or force in wire is okay. Now we will find the stress in wire AB. So stress in wire AB is equal to force in AB divided by area of AB. So force is 3600 divided by area is pi by 4. Again, diameter is 0.004 square. So when you solve this, you will get stress will be equal to 286.48 megapascal. And you can see this is greater than yield stress, which is 250 megapascal. So it means that this is not good. So what we will do, why not good? Because it is given that material behave elastically, perfectly plastic, and it is exceeding the yield stress. So what we do is that I will write it, since wire AB yields, so the elastic analysis is not valid and the solution must be reworked. So how you will rework? So we will use that, we know that yield stress is equal to force into area. So from here, this force in AB will be equal to, we will calculate force based on yield stress so that it lies within the yielding range. So we will know that yield stress into this area of AB will give force. So yield stress is 250 megapascal. So 250 into 10 raised to the power 6 multiplied by area is pi by 4. Diameter is 0.004 square. So when you solve this, you will get FAB, and FAB will be 3141.59 Newton, or you can say that this FAB will be equal to 3.14 kilo Newton. Now you have this force, clear? And what we will do is that we will put FAB is equal to 3.14 kilonewton in equation 1 or 2. So if I put it in equation number 2, so I will also get FCD will be equal to 2.72 kilonewton. Now again we will check the stresses, clear? So for that I will calculate CD is equal to FCD divided by area of CD. So FCD, which was new calculated, was 2.72 kilonewton. So 2.72 into 10 to the power 3 divided by pi by 4 into 0.004 square. So when you solve this, you will get 216.20 megapascal. And now you can see this is less than yield stress, which is 250 megapascal. So it means that it is still okay. So answers that force in wire AB is equal to, and force in wire CD is equal to, so force in wire CD is 2.72 kilonewton and force in wire AB is 3.14 kilonewton. So this is the answer of our first part. Now moving toward next part, that is determine elongation in both wire AB and in wire AB and CD. So how you will find this? We know that elongation, change in length of CD, is equal to FCD into LCD divided by A into E. So FCD is 2.72 into 10 raised to the power 3 multiplied by length of each wire is given as 300 millimeter. So I will multiply it with 0.3 meter divided by area, which is pi by 4 into 0.004 square multiply by E, which is 200 gigapascal. You can check the property, 200 into 10 raised to the power 9. When you solve this, it will give you 0.000324 meter. Or you can say change in length of wire CD will be equal to 0.324 millimeter. Now we'll find change in length of AB. So change in length of AB is equal to FAB into LAB divided by area of AB into E. Put the values. FAB is 3.14 into 10 raised to the power 3 Newton. Length is same, which is 0.300 divided by same diameter, because the diameter is same area, because the diameter is same and same material. So modulus of elasticity is 200 gigapascal, which is 200 into 10 raised to the power 9. So when you solve this, you will get 0.000649 meter. Or you can say change in length of AB is equal to 0.649 millimeter. Also, you can solve this by using this equation as well. Let me show the equation here. This is the equation. You can also calculate it if you know delta CD. So we can also calculate delta AB is equal to 2 times delta CD. So 2 multiplied by delta CD is 0.324. So it will be again equal to 0.649 millimeter. So change in length of wire AB is equal to 0.649 millimeter, and change in length of CD is 0.324 millimeter. And these are the answers of our second part. So this was all about this problem 4-101. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Also share my videos with your friends and help me in growing my channel further. Thank you for watching.